What's My Line? Brought to you by Kellogg's. Kellogg's Cereals. The best to you each morning from Kellogg's of Battle Creek. Now let's all play What's My Line? And now, live from New York, let's meet our What's My Line panel. First, the delightful star of stage and television, Miss Arlene Francis.
And now, a marvelous comedian who gives a joyous performance in the most joyful of all pictures this year, Love a Comeback, Mr. Tony Randall.
That from one of the stars of 1, 2, 3.
Thank you.
It is my pleasure to introduce a lady who is a famous reporter, a charming woman, and a great twister, Dorothy Kilgallen.
Thank you, Tony. And I would like to introduce the gentleman who is the head of a very famous and distinguished publishing firm, Random House, Mr. Bennett Cerf.
Panel moderator, as you know, is a very famous newscaster, too. In fact, Dr. Seuss, the famous Cat in the Hat man, told me that a California institution was going to give him a new degree this year, an honorary degree, Bachelor of Oratory. But then they suddenly realized what the initials of Bachelor of Oratory were, B.O., and they're going to give him another degree entirely. Here he is, the great newscaster, John Daly.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to What's My Line. Now we come to the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery challenger, for which the members of the panel, as you all know, are blindfolded. Blindfolds all in place, panel?
Yes, sir.
Good. Will you enter, mystery challenger, and sign in, please? Panel, a different form of questioning, one question at a time, in turn, moving clockwise, and we'll begin with Mr. Randall.
May I assume from those whistles that they are fairly earned?
Well, yes. Now, was that a point of information, or do you want to consider that a question, Mr. Randall?
My question was, are you a young lady?
That's fine. That's no. Yeah. One down and 90
oh!
Miss Kilgallen.
Wow.
I was so set up for Kim Novak after that remark and the okay. applause.
I've been set up for Kim Novak for...
All right. Are you a performer of some kind?
A performer in the sense of movies, television, that sort of thing? Darcy?
Or sports,
but an actual performer...
Someone who performs before the public and the people pay to see it.
Yes.
Mr. Cerf?
This literally breaks my heart, but I must disqualify myself this evening, because I know who the mystery guest is.
Miss Francis?
Well, is it a figure in the sports world?
Not presently.
Now, I must change that answer to a resounding yes. Mr. Randall?
Well, I'll have to go the obvious route and ask if you're connected with the Mets.
Yes.
Are you Casey Stengel?
He sure is. Now, As one of the new fans that Casey has played such a large part in creating of the Mets, I'm not at all downhearted, sir, that you were a towering giant in the sports field, and I think the Mets are going to go on and write their name large in sports history. After all, you've just had a little time to get started, and you've got a long, hard job, as you've said yourself so many times, so we don't get disheartened yet, Dorothy.
Well, I was going to say, Mr. Stengel, that I don't know too much about baseball. In fact, I'm pretty dumb about it. But I do know about New Yorkers, and I think we've needed an underdog team for a long time, and the same people who were rooting for the Dodgers and a lot who've rooted for Mr. Stengel in the past are going to be out screaming their heads off for him and for the Mets.
John.
Thank you very much.
John, can I explain, Casey, why I knew it was going to be Casey? I've been begging him. We're publishing Casey's book, Casey at the Bat. I've been begging him to come on this show for months. And finally, with the assistance, the very valuable assistance of his lovely wife, Edna, we talked him into coming tonight. And we're mighty glad to have you, Casey.
Well, there's so many splendid people and experts, you know. I didn't think that I could qualify to ever appear on their show.
Oh, Casey, you qualified to appear on this show a long, long time ago. Was it 9 pennants in 12 years? That qualifies you for 55 appearances on What's My Line. And we're tickled. Actually, Casey doesn't like to get on television, and we're very tickled that he finally broke down and decided to join us. I'll tell Toot Shore that you finally gave in, because he said you'd never do it.
What do you think of the team, Casey? What are you going to do about the Mets? Have you got some plans for...
Well, you know, it's a little snowy today. It was about fourth inning there, and we're not used to playing in the snow, and the first game it rained, and we're not used to playing in the rain. Then, too, I'm so interested in writing that Casey at the Bat to see that it's sold that I haven't been thinking of the right things for the last 4 days. From now on, I'll do my work right.
Okay. Casey is more than an expert at baseball. He's an expert in speech. Thank you, Casey. Wonderful. Oh, that was great.
Let's have him back soon.
I think we ought to. I think we ought to, too. And I must say it's load of fun to have Casey here. I don't know if we'll have time. I'm afraid we won't be able to make another contestant right away quick, but we might try it in a bit. We'll try another contestant after this word from our alternate sponsor.